Aluminium boasts many amazing properties which make it an extremely resourceful metal for a multitude of uses. This is why, along with steel, aluminium is now one of the most widely used metals in the world. However, when you think of aluminium, your first thought may not go to strength. Your empty drink can isn't exactly hard to crush, and kitchen foil would lose all its purpose if it were not flexible. Yet, when fabricated with the purpose of strength, aluminium can be stronger than you may imagine and is more malleable than any other typically strong metals such as steel. Now, let us explore its fantastic characteristics even further. Around 75% of all aluminium ever made is still in use. In fact, according to the Aluminium Association, this metal is the most recyclable material on Earth. In the United Kingdom specifically, over 8 billion aluminium cans are recycled each year. Pretty cool, right? Thousands of years ago, the ancient Greeks used to dye their clothes with alum, an aluminium-based salt. Of course, industrial production of this metal began much later, sometime in the 19th century, in fact, after the Hall-Holt process had been invented. Aluminium is the planet's most abundant metallic element, second only to silicon. Incredibly, around 8% of the Earth's crust is made of it. Did you know that a significant amount of aluminium was also found on the moon too? Do not get confused though. Pure aluminium is not found in the natural world, as it must be manufactured from a collection of ores. Aluminium makes up an astounding 75 to 80% of a modern aircraft, including fighter jets and cargo planes. It is ideal for aircraft manufacturing for similar reasons as automobiles, given that it is both light and strong. Being roughly one-third the weight of steel, it allows an aircraft to carry more cargo and passengers, improving fuel efficiency while maintaining strength and stability. Concorde, which flew passengers at over twice the speed of sound for 27 years, from 1969 to 2003, was built with an aluminium skin. For decades, aluminium was seen as more precious than silver or even gold. This is all down to the fact that before the Bayer Hall-Holt process were discovered, it was perceived as extremely rare. So rare, in fact, that Napoleon III used aluminium plates and cutlery for his formal guests. Doesn't sound very glamorous, does it? Aluminium can support significant weight without weighing a building down, making it an ideal material to use in skyscrapers and other large structures. It can support large, heavy glass panes that promote natural light throughout a structure. Therefore, it is used for many curtain wall and facade systems. Skyscrapers and other large commercial buildings also use aluminium across their structure for door frames, window frames, side panelling and roofing. Aluminium is the second most used material by automakers, from cars, lorries and buses to even ocean liners. Aluminium has seen a huge rise in car makers' manufacturing practices due to its innate strength, ability to absorb impact energy and lightweight nature. This weight and strength combination, something other metals like steel just do not possess, contributes to a CO2 reduction as lighter cars substantially improve fuel efficiency, which is great news for fuel-guzzling cargo vessels. Although it might not be at the top of your bucket list, if you're planning on swimming with sharks, you would hopefully be braving them in an aluminium cage. Computers have suggested that a 6.5 meter great white shark would produce nearly 4,000 pounds per square inch of bite force. By contrast, you might tear into a steak with 150 to 200 pounds per square inch. Hyenas, lions and tigers only generally generate around 1,000 psi. Yet, aluminium will keep you securely safe in a durable crate fit for saltwater exposure and any predatory attack. To be honest, both spellings are correct. Sir Humphrey Davy named the element aluminium in 1808, but 4 years later he changed it to aluminum. While British English uses aluminium for reasons of consistency and parity with other resources like calcium and sodium, our American English-speaking cousins use aluminum.